my background is integrated circuit design, manufacturing, and testing, and in particular testing, meaning that when circuits are fabricated, not all of them work. And we call this yield, yield of 80%. 90% means that 90 out of 100 chips will actually work. Now, when you're dealing with a safety critical application, say autonomous vehicles, you want all the chips to be working. Now, automobiles are known to be safety critical applications, but there are other applications where defective chips can cause issues. And this is in the world of Google and Amazon and Facebook. These companies have hundreds of thousands of servers. And when chips get into these servers, things fail, and they don't know that they failed. So Google has approached us to come up with a different way, different technique for testing these chips. And we're doing something that we call pseudo-exhaustive physically aware testing, meaning that we take a design, we chop it up into over a billion pieces, and we test each one of those designs individually. At the moment, we've applied our technique to over 30,000 failing chips. Some of these chips were detected in serendipitous ways, meaning that they were accidentally found to be defective. With our approach, we found that we could directly detect these defects, which is way beyond the state of the art, meaning that we can have higher quality levels than the type that Google is looking for. Our technique requires a huge amount of testing. So right now, the cost of test is very sensitive and people try to minimize it. And we're ignoring that cost at the moment. So there's going to be a great need in the future to optimize the way we do this physically aware, pseudo-exhaustive testing. So in summary, companies like Google, where compute is part of their business model, is critical to their business model, they have to understand that their hardware works correctly. And that begins with actually providing defect-free chips to them for their server business. This is not only going to be an issue for companies like Google, Facebook, and Amazon, but also in transactions that involve Bitcoin. One can imagine if defective parts are actually doing compute for Bitcoin and other types of complex transactions and data mining, that other issues can arise very quickly.